Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. In this video series, we're going to be having a look at the workflow scenarios between the tracking application Mocha Pro and Autodesk Smoke. We'll mainly concentrate on how to set up Mocha Pro to export data into Smoke, and how Smoke can import this data to be used to complete compositing tasks. This includes working with tracking data, garbage masks, and 3D tracking information via the FBX interchange file format. For our example, this tracking shot is being used as part of an advertisement for a recycling campaign. The final composite that is currently playing in the player consists of a picture insertion, rotoscoping, and a 3D model. All the elements were composited in Smoke using the metadata from Mocha Pro. Here is the original shot before all the items were added. You can download this clip as well as the Mocha Pro files and metadata exports from the description section on the YouTube page, or you can go to the link displayed at the bottom of the video. We'll start off with the first element, that is the logo insertion on the side of the truck. We'll switch over into Mocha Pro, where my file is already loaded and the track has been completed. I'll just turn on the matte overlays and tell Mocha Pro to show them all. So now you can see all the elements have been tracked in the shot. Mocha is a planar tracker. This means it tracks textured areas of an image rather than the point tracker in Autodesk Smoke. There are many applications for planar tracking, and one of them is image insertion, or some might call pack shot replacement. In this case, I have used Mocha Pro to track the side of the truck. I have also tracked the van and excluded it from the main track as it goes in front of the truck at certain times. For more information on Mocha Pro and tutorials on how to use Mocha Pro, please visit Imagineer Systems website. To map the logo on the side of the truck, we need to perform a 4-point data export from Mocha Pro. In preparation for this, we need to set the planar surface coordinates for the 4-point track. First, select the layer containing the truck shape. The shape around the truck is the search area for the tracker. In order to place the logo on the truck, I need to enable the planar surface to establish the four corners for the 4-point track that will ultimately be exported. You can grab each corner and position them to the edge of the truck so that the perspective of the surface matches the truck's side. You can use the magnifier to accurately see your positioning. This will give a good indication that the tracking matches the shot. You can see how the planar surface sticks to the side of the truck, and Smoke will be able to take this data in order to map an image onto the truck with a 4-point bilinear surface. To export this data to Smoke, make sure you switch to the Track tab. Click Export Tracking Data. And in the pop-up menu, change the format to the Autodesk Stabilizer Data. Click Save and navigate to a folder where you would like to save the setup. Let's just call this Truck and press Save. Going into Smoke, I have my shot already in a sequence, and I'll add a Connect Effects onto the shot. In the Connect Effects node bin, you can drag out an action node and drop it into the connection. In the media library, I also have a logo to be tracked onto the truck. Select and drag the source clip into the Connect Effects schematic. This source clip is an imported image file that contains an alpha channel as a matte container. To add this image as a layer for the action composite, select the action node and press Ctrl+N to add a new media input for action. Now connect the fill into the red input and the alpha into the blue input of the media node. Double-click on the action node and press Escape over the Connect Effects schematic to bring up the action schematic. So what you should see in the schematic is the axis and image nodes for the logo image. This image is currently flat, and you need to change it to a bilinear surface to work with 4-point tracking. double-click on the image surface that will bring up the surface menu. Here you can change the surface mode from flat to bilinear. Notice how there are now control points on every corner of the image. These can be moved around and positioned to match the truck. But since the tracking has already been done in Mocha Pro, you can just load the settings. Switch to the vertices menu and click the stabilizer button to enter into the tracker. In the interface, you are given four trackers with each tracker representing a corner of the image. When you export the Autodesk stabilizer data from Mocha Pro, you get one file containing all the tracking data. Press the load button. In the file browser, navigate to the folder with the exported tracking data. Select the truck file, and it automatically loads the tracking data. Now you can see that when I scrub the time bar, all four trackers are correctly positioned on the truck. If you were not using Mocha Pro to do the tracking, you could have used the stabilizer in Smoke to do the tracking. Exit the stabilizer, and now we have a surface mapped onto the side of the truck and it matches the movement. The logo may require additional offsetting, blurring, and color correction in Smoke, but this should do for now. In the next video, we need to bring the van back into the foreground so that the logo and the truck are always behind it. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.